How's it going, bro? My name is PewDiePie, and welcome to the final episode of the Stanley Parable. If you've already seen the intro, I'm going to leave an annotation to skip it or something like that, but if not, we're going to sit through it.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427, and he pushed buttons on a keyboard.
There's no keyboard.
Orders came to him through a monitor next to his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy.
He doesn't look very happy, in my opinion, but that's just my opinion.
And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget.
What is it?
He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on a monitor for him to follow.
Oh, no.
No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi.
I can't believe it.
Never in all his years at the company had this happened. This complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and walked out into the hallway.
All right, let's do this, bros. I don't even know if I can do the endings. We'll
Stanley
see.
Decided to go to the staff lounge to check on his co-workers.
What?
He never functioned well by himself and constantly needed support and guidance from others. So the thought of total solitude was terrifying to him.
Are you bros like that? I'm really the opposite of
when
that.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
I don't remember how I'm supposed to get this ending. I think I'm supposed to go in the right one. I'm not
sure. This was not the correct way to the employee lounge, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. So he turned left at the first open door and walked back in the right direction.
Nah, I think it's here, actually.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Shut up!
Maybe this is why everyone had left. No one wanted to be around someone as bad at listening as him. And since
true.
He was walking into the middle of nowhere and thus ruining the entire story, Stanley decided that he would punish himself. So when he came to the elevator and the doors opened, he stepped inside and pushed the button to go up.
Oh, I think I messed up. No, wait, this is correct. Don't worry. Now I just gotta think, was it up or down? No, wait, it's gotta be down. Yep. This is correct.
Oh, Stanley.
What?
You know, you really aren't going anywhere, and I don't say that deceitfully. I truthfully mean that there isn't a story down here.
Yes, there is. There's three endings
down there.
The story
is where I told you to go in the first place.
Don't lie to me.
Right now, you're just running around looking at empty halls. And frankly, that's perhaps even more infuriating for me.
Well,
so why don't you throw me a bone? Give me a chance and just let me tell the story I want to tell.
Hmm? You don't have any bones. You don't have any bones. Okay, let's think, bros. Let's not fuck up the ata. Okay, yes, here it is.
Now listen carefully. Uh-huh. This is important.
Yes.
Stanley walked through the red door.
The red door. Yep. Here it is. I don't know what I feel about this. Hello? What? Red door? Where does this go? Hello? Ah!
Good. Good. Now, if you don't mind, there's something I'd like to show you.
His dick.
To do that, I think it would be best for us to start from the beginning.
Are you gonna take me out on a date? What? What's going on?
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stanley.
What? What the? Okay.
Stanley worked for a company in a big building.
No!
Where he was employee number 427. His job pushing buttons demanded little of him, so there was not much of himself to give. And in this way, Stanley's job felt less and less like his every day. But if buttons need pushing one day, it means they'll need pushing the next, and then the next. So, without question or judgment, Stanley continued to do what the screen told him.
Okay.
One keystroke flowed into another keystroke, flowed into his ride home, flowed into dinner, flowed into waking up, flowed into going to work, and here he was again. Stanley was typing out a complete sentence that said absolutely nothing at all.
What was it? What did
If in reality no one ever actually disappeared from the office, and Stanley never got the opportunity to make a decision, to choose which path he wanted to take, would his life still have any meaning? Perhaps when we long for something deeply enough, these hopes and fantasies become so strong in our minds that we truly believe that we're there, controlling that person and living that adventure. To manipulate your own thoughts and emotions might mean freedom from a self-imposed prison. But these delusions can be fatal to those who can't tell the difference.
This is true.
And so, Stanley asked, if that door never opened, if I'll never be able to walk away from those people and from these buttons, is this life still worth experiencing? Am I actually happy? Stanley answered this question by pushing a button.
Please don't.
Then he pushed a button, and then he pushed a button.
No.
Then he pushed a button. Then he pushed a button.
Then he pushed a butt. That's a deep ending. This game is so deep. God damn it. Give me goosebumps. I like that ending. That was a cool one. We got one more, brichachos, so don't even worry about it. I just don't remember how you get it. But we'll see. We don't have to do the intro this time around.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
The left one. All right, I'm doing as you say, mystery man. Okay, what else? Refrigerator, what's going on? Oh, the lounge.
As Stanley entered the lounge, he was horrified to find not a single person here. He decided he would walk up to see his boss, hoping that he would find an answer there.
Oh yeah, my boss is here. Okay. So this is where you make the difference. You go downstairs.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Upstairs, okay, I gotcha.
But Stanley just couldn't do it. He considered the possibility of facing his boss.
Yep.
Of admitting that he had left his post during work hours.
What?
He might be fired for that.
This is true.
And in such a competitive economy,
it's
really worth taking that risk? All because he believed everyone had disappeared.
Yep.
His boss would think he was crazy. And then something occurred to Stanley.
What?
Maybe, he thought to himself, maybe I am crazy.
No, you're not.
Everyone I know simply vanishing out of the blue, there's almost no other explanation for it.
Yeah.
And a nagging fear began to creep up in his mind.
What?
Questions that had been there all along. He just hadn't put his finger on them yet.
What is it?
For example, why couldn't he see his feet when he looked down? Why did doors close automatically behind him wherever he went?
Yeah, what?
And for that matter, these rooms were starting to look pretty familiar.
Yeah!
Was he just walking around in
circles? No!
Where am I? He thought. And the more he found himself unable to answer these questions, the more questions continued to arise, until he came to the issue that had been slowly boiling until he could ignore it no longer.
Oh no.
Why is there a voice in my head?
Yeah, where is it?
Dictating everything that I'm doing and thinking.
This is true.
Suddenly, every door slammed
shut. No!
Stanley screamed. I need to get out of here.
I need to get out of here.
That there's something out there. I need to know it's not just all in my head.
And he
screamed and clutched at his skull as the voice grew harsher.
Pump the walls.
And the music in the background rose higher and higher. And then, moments before collapsing to the ground, Stanley clenched his fists and screamed to anyone who might be listening.
I'm gay!
I'm not real! I'm not real! Don't believe any of it! None of it's real!
I like the music.
And then everything went black.
Oh no! This game is
this
so...
This is the story of a woman named Mariella. Mariella woke up on a day like any other.
Okay, Mariella.
She got dressed, went to work, clocked in, clocked out, and then she walked home. But her walk on this day was interrupted by the body of a man
Stanley.
Who had stumbled through town talking and screaming to himself, and then collapsed dead on the sidewalk. Moments after seeing him, she would turn, run to the nearest police station, and call for an ambulance. But for just a few brief seconds, she merely stood there, unable to move. The tragedy was not the death of a single person. It was that she would never know this man's story, never hear in his own words what had happened to him, or what he believed had happened to him. For to know these things would be to exist inside the head of the man himself. So all she could do was observe from a distance and pity him. But Mariella had places to be and people to meet with, very important people, whose impressions of her would affect her career and indeed the rest of her life. She stood there for only a moment, looking down at the body, and then she ran.
And that was the Stanley Parable, bros. That was awesome. That was probably one of the best mods I have ever played. That's so awesome. Every ending of this game were really, like, thought-provoking and interesting. And I didn't get all of them the first, but I read your bros' comments, so I did understand it. And I think that was kind of cool. I think your bros enjoyed it. I enjoyed it a lot. Leave a like if you enjoyed watching. Hit subscribe to become a bro today, and I'll see you in the next mod, game, whatever we're gonna play. Stay awesome, bros. Love you. My name is Grandpa, and welcome to
Friday for Grandpa.
On an actual Friday. Hey, high five. Let's do it. Why would you not high five me?